Hello, crystal lovers and friends. Laura Weigel here with another video about crystals. So to continue with my theme on self-love and to kind of combine that with the energies that's going on right now, I wanted to talk about how you can incorporate crystals for self-love and what that really means with this Mercury retrograde. And if you don't know, we have Mercury retrograding right now in the sign of Pisces. And Mercury really, it governs Virgo, which I am, and Gemini. And it is the sign governing our thinking, our communication, and decision-making. A lot of times people really get scared of Mercury retrograde because they feel like we have a lot of miscommunications. Things can break down technologically for us. But when you think about it in terms of it's retrograding, so it's appearing to go backwards for us, it really is just a time to remind us to slow down. It's a time to review. So when you think of it in those terms, it's kind of a welcomed energy. We can't go forward all the time. We need to review, we need to reflect, and we need to go within. So the energy is really supportive of that right now. And of course, we're in the month of February, and my theme has been self-love for this whole month. So how can we incorporate self-love and Mercury retrograde? First and foremost, I'm gonna say rose quartz, of course. I have this big, huge hunk of this beautiful raw rose quartz. Rose quartz because it will really help in terms of communication, but how you're communicating with yourself, because rose quartz teaches self-love, self-compassion, self-forgiveness, and what we're feeding ourselves is what we're then emitting to the world and then attracting back to ourselves, you know? And so I think it's really important to watch what we're feeding ourselves, rose quartz. Also, amazonite is another one. Amazonite helps to give us courage. It connects the heart and the throat center, so helping us to speak our truth, but from our heart. And in terms of self-love, it's really about getting raw and real with ourselves, you know, and speaking that truth to ourselves, which brings me to my third recommendation, which is Labradorite. Labradorite helps to bring the subconscious to the conscious. It helps us to reflect on a deeper level. It shines the light on those situations that we need to see. And so by having the courage to speak about those things, whether that's to somebody that you need to speak to or just really in terms of speaking it to yourself, those are my three recommendations. You know, rose quartz, amazonite, labradorite, having the courage. And amazonite also clears out that like electromagnetic smog that you may absorb around you. So it really helps you to speak more clearly as well. And then lastly, I added in fluorite. This is a beautiful rainbow fluorite. There's some white, some purple, and some green in it. This is my personal fluorite sphere. The reason I added fluorite then is because it helps us to think more clearly. It's connected with our crown chakra. And during Mercury retrograde, we can overthink. We cannot have clear thinking. We might not see situations clearly. And so the fluorite helps us to kind of calm down our thinking, to see things more clearly. It's a great stone to meditate with as well. All of them truly are. But I feel like if you have a big decision, which they, meaning astrologers, I guess, will advise against making big decisions if you have to during Mercury retrograde. But for 3 weeks and in our busy life, sometimes that's not very feasible. But either way, whether you're making a big decision or not, this will help you to become more clear about it. So definitely journaling with that, and check out my blog post because I will be including some affirmations, the crystals, and some journaling prompts, and a fun personal story that brought in some more insight for me during this Mercury retrograde. So I hope you found this useful. If you did, please like, subscribe, and and share and give me some feedback of your thoughts of what crystals you like during Mercury retrograde, or how you use your crystals during Mercury retrograde, which my blog post will also include my tips on how to use each one of these crystals. Until next time, namaste.